thankful that we are together again.
Yes, amen.
And as we press through and press in, let's pray that God will give us a covering that would help us to understand what He wants us to understand today.
Yes.
Because the Word of God is a mystery, and it's there's several terms that are addressed with the term mystery, but one of them is the mystery of godliness. And I think that through our experience and in serving the Lord, that we can grow, and as children do, they grow one bit at a time. They begin to walk after they've crawled, and they learn how to maintain their abilities and learn how to eat by themselves. And I think the Bible uses a lot of framework to describe how the child of God grows in the kingdom of God. And Peter said that Paul said in Hebrews 5, he said, why we need to sincerely open the Word of God, the lighter things of the Word of God. And I think that we need that truth in our hearts. And none of us ought to feel like we are above learning, because learning is what this is all about. We learn one step at a time. We learn how to be continuously faithful. And then we're, as I was trying to recall, but we are to sincerely seek the Word of God, the wonderful things, the principles of the Word of God. He told His followers, he told the Israelites that were around Him, and He said, I wish you would go back to the milk and not go after the meat, because you're not qualified for the meat. Paul told his followers that, and because Paul too had touched the hearts of many Gentiles, but also a remnant of Jewish people that he had around him. And sometimes the followers of the religions, the Jewish concept, followed Jesus and followed Paul. And a lot of times he had to rebuke them. But he said, I wish you would go back to the very basic principles. And then he continues the next chapter, and he opens up with the four major doctrines. And he said that we may, and I can't quote it exactly, but that we may comprehend the doctrine of baptism, the doctrine of laying on of hands, the doctrine of resurrection, and the eternal judgment doctrine, those four major doctrines. And he said, now listen what Paul said. He said, this will do if God permits. So God has to be in favor of the people receiving that. And he has to have his hand on their lives, because a lot of folks have studied the Bible for years and years, and they've done it in the confines of a home, or they've done it in the confines of a religious group, or even possibly within the body of Christ, and they studied, but did not get anywhere with an understanding. They had a knowledge, but the knowledge has to be turned into an understanding, that understanding turns in a living principle in a person's life. And if that understanding doesn't develop into that, then don't be surprised that you lose that understanding, because everything else takes precedence over the Word of God, and that's what causes a person to lose their understanding. Just like if you had a hankering for the ice cream with a Tootsie Roll crumbled up in it, and you really had a hankering for it, If you ate enough of it, you would get tired of it. But after a while, if you keep staying away from that, holding back, not being a part of it, then what happens is you lose that desire, and you lose that no matter how much you like whatever they call it, cookie dough or whatever they call it. I don't know what it is. I just bypass it in the store. But that you lose that concept, or you lose that desire. Just like if you have a certain regimentation of how to work in the business world, or in the workforce, and you had a certain regimentation. If you're not exposed to it and not brought up to date, you lose that regimentation. Just like I was very accomplished in the areas of business in the world, but I would be like a sore thumb in there now, because things have changed, and things have escalated into a greater volume of knowledge that they have. And that's the same way with the work of the Lord. If we study and study certain ways and certain regimentation of how things should be, and we don't follow up, and as you do with your computer, get updates, then you will lose that very desire. It'll leave you. It'll go. It'll leave its motivation is dwindles and diminishes into nothing. But here today, we're here to honor Jesus Christ. We honor Him in praise. We honor Him in exhortation. We honor Him in our voices as we sing, and we get up and testify, and we administer praise to others, and try to show the right spirit to others. But here today, we as children of God can grow and honor Jesus Christ, because we're not only to do those things, but we're also to attain that food that we need to produce. Just like your cell structure, if you don't eat, your cells start breaking down. And if you don't keep eating the right things, then your body starts breaking down. And it's the same way with the work of the Lord. Our soul has to be fed and has to receive from the Word of God. I'll share a couple scriptures. I don't want to take all the time, except all the time that God allots me. But before we do that, why don't we lift our hands in praise and honor to the Lord, and ask the Lord to help those that are sick. Praise God. We appreciate you, dear Lord. In the name of Jesus, we glorify. We glorify. Lord, cover us today. Give us what we need today. In the name of Jesus Christ, bless your wonderful name. Bless your wonderful name. Bless your wonderful name. Praise God. Praise God. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. I think I went through these a few weeks ago, so I won't go through them in depth. But I've had such a burden in my heart for the restoration of the church, and that we get in the right order. And I've heard, and I've sought the wisdom of men, ministers in the past. I've dug into information from them. I've heard different philosophies, different thoughts on it, and everybody has a certain thought, but none of them seem to really grasp my spirit and to get my heart into a place that I can comfortably feel that I have a goal and a purpose. Now, that doesn't mean that I don't have a goal and a purpose, but it means that I want to see I want to have that purpose that God wants for His work today, because His work is the most important endeavor in my heart and in my spirit, to see God's work prosper. And sometimes I cut my vacation short because I want to be in church. I don't let the affairs of this world, I even tell them in Bay Pines, don't schedule me for certain schedules, because I won't keep them, because I'll be in church, or I'll be preparing to be in church. And because this is my life,
yes, amen.
As the chorus we sing, this is my life. This is what I live for.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Yes. What's the rest of the code says? This is my life. This is what I live for. To be with God's people. Oh, praise God. In this hour. Amen. And what's the other?
Just to be a part.
Just to be a part.
Of what He's doing.
Of what He's doing.
I can feel it in my soul.
Now, I'm going to a meeting, if God permits. I'm going to a meeting in Las Vegas, Nevada. Now, that is the gambling capital of the world. But, and I've already got potential reservations in one of the motels there, and but I'm not going to walk the turf there.
No.
I'm going to be in a meeting.
Yes.
In a fellowship meeting with Brother Catrone. And Brother Catrone is a man that was on death row. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He was on death row. Mm-hmm. He was going to be sentenced. Brother Catrone was with Hell's Angels, and they sure were a group that caused a lot of pain and hurt in the 60s, 70s, and the 50s even. But Brother Catrone was sitting on death row. And the governor of that state, and I can't recall what state it was. It might
California.
Have been California. The state of California. And the governor had a new program. And he went to his cell. And he let him out of that cell. And he went on to give his life to the Lord Jesus Christ,
amen.
Received the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and became a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God had to do that for him,
yes,
wouldn't you say?
Amen.
God had to do that for him.
Yes,
and Brother Catrone sent me a letter a few days ago and asked me to come. Never been to Las Vegas. All the cities in the world I've been to, Las Vegas has not been one. I never had a hankering to go to Las Vegas. Joel's been there two or three times, but I don't have that feeling to even be there. But I have a feeling to be with God's people.
Yes.
And wherever they gather, God, if God's for them, He'll protect them.
Yes.
He'll keep them. And whatever it takes, Lord, wherever we need to go, whatever we need to do, that the powerful language of the Bible that has helped us to bring the truth back into focus, the first truth, major truth that was rediscovered, should I say, or re-implemented, was the step of a person in conversion, receiving the baptism.